going to show four balls animation. For this I have made a long bar, and I have made a rectangle with 300 millimeter long and 30 millimeter wide, and I have put a 15 millimeters in diameter circle with 15 millimeters from each edge, and I have put a center line, and I have mirrored that circle, and I have exist and extruded with 10 millimeter width, and then I have used a fillet, edge fillet, and selected all those four edges with 15 millimeter radius. Then I have made a short bar, and I have made a 115 millimeter long and 30 millimeter width, and I have put a circle with 15 millimeter in diameter and 15 millimeter from each side, and I have put a center line, and I have mirrored that circle, and I have exited the sketch, and I have extruded with 10 millimeter thick, and I have made the edge fillet with 15 millimeter radius. Now I am going to understand mechanical design, assembly design, and I have selected the product, and I have a right click, and select components, existing component, and I take a long, and it is okay. I accept it as it is. I am going to right click on the product, select components, existing component, and I select open the short bar, which is over the inside that the long bar. The reason is that I have designed it from the same coordinates, and extruded in the same direction. Now I am going to select the manipulation palette, and it is a X direction, and I select the X translation, and select short bar, and keep the left mouse key and draw. Okay. Now I am going again to select that one manipulation palette, and I select the rotate through an axis, and this axis is selected, and I select the bar and rotate. Now I am going to make a coincident constraint between that one and rotate, and between that one, that axis. It is a constraint, but it is not fully constraint. I am going to select the offset constraint and select that face and that face. The distance between them is 24. Now I make it 0 you see that the distance is zero, but it doesn't happen anything, I am going to select the update. Now they are sitting over each other. I am going to again right click on product one, components, existing component, and I open the short bar, and I am going to make a constraint between that axis is activate, and I am going to make an update, and I am going to select the offset, select that face and that face, and the distance must be zero, and update. Now it is okay. Now I am going to select the manipulation palette, and rotation through axis is activated. Now I select that one and rotate that one. Okay. I am going to hide that dimension and hide that dimension. Now I am going to right click on product and select the long bar, and I am going to make a constraint between that one and that one. Again, a constraint between that one and that one. Now I am going to use the update, and I am going to select the offset between that face and that face and make it zero. Now you see that all of them are sitting over each other. I am going to use manipulate and select that one and draw. It is okay as it is. I am going to select that dimension and hide. Now our design is fully constrained, and I am going to under start digital mock-up cinematic, and I am going to use the Revolut joint, and I am going to make a new mechanism, UCO. short bar on the plane. I am going to use that plane. We must have a fixed part, and I select the fixed part in mechanism, and I select the first long bar, and it appeared that fixed over there. Now I can when I use the joint, the second joint, I am going to angle driven and let it from minus 360 degrees to 360 degrees okay. And the mechanism can be simulated now. And I am going to select the simulation mechanism one, and I am going to insert, use that one, and use that ratio, and select UCO. Okay, it seems that it doesn't accept. Cancel. Again, simulation, select the mechanism OK. Now it is coming from minus 360 degrees to 360 degrees, and I am keep it to show how it is working, and I am going to use insert and select the ratio to to 0.02, and I'm going to use the return, and it's going as we wanted. If you want it, you can go to Revolut 2, edit definition, and I am beginning from 0 to 360 degrees. Now I'm going to make a simulation, select the mechanism, OK, and now it is from 0 to 360 degrees, and I increase it. And it standing there. Now I'm going to use insert. And the ratio I'm going to make in 0.04, little quicker. And it's going as I wished. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.